I'm Aaron, and today I'm reviewing my season one Goldor without the wings. And he had, I'll show you the box first. Here's the front of the box with him in it. You can see his accessories, well, most of them, because some of them are behind. And I absolutely love this box. The one thing I do wish Hasbro would do, and please do this, Hasbro, now you've started listening to your fans, because I will tag you in this like I have done other videos. I wish that Hasbro had actually put pictures of them that were actually from the show, not like cartoony pictures, just normal pictures of them from the show. So Hasbro, please do that. So here's the side of the box with his face on it, or part of his face on it. Here's the other side with his half his crown on the other side. And now I will show you the back of the box. Here he is on the back of the box, in a pose, which I really like the pose. Now, you may notice that the back of the box, the colour gold, is completely different to the actual colour of the main figure itself. Now, I really hate the colour they've done it. It's what I term as the melty cheese gold. If you've seen the 2017 movie, you'll know what I mean. But I really hate the way they've done it, the gold, which is actually yellow. And so, like my season two one with the wings, I'm going to have to repaint this one, which is a pain in the ass to paint these, to be honest. It's a real pain in the ass. But I'm going to do it because it makes them look better. But the only thing only problem I have with these Lightning Collection figures, especially if they're supposed to be gold, is you pay all that money for a figure that is supposed to be gold or supposed to have the right colour suit, and you pay all that money and you get the figure itself, and then when you actually get it in your hands and you look at it, it's not the right colour. So I wish Hasbro would fix that. So Hasbro, if you're listening, please fix it. And also, I'm also going to say this to the Power Rangers design team. Please fix this, the guys at the Power Rangers design team at Hasbro, because this is really annoying to a lot of people. I've seen a lot of comments on YouTube, Facebook, even on your Hasbro Facebook, I've seen comments, and all of the comments I've seen have told you to use the right colour on these figures. Because, I mean, even MMPR Toys has told you that, and you know how big he is because you work with him sometimes. So please do the right gold for these figures. And now, let's take it out of the box and have a good look, shall we? So, here he is out of the box. I love the way he looks. I absolutely love him. But it's the colour that gets me. It really does. He's got spare hands. Which look absolutely fantastic. The effects piece on the sword and the sword, which I think is the same exact figure, so this is kind of weird. The bit on the sword with the gold on with the wings, the lightning bit is a lot thicker and stronger, so it doesn't fall off the sword all the time. Because every time I tried to put it on the one you got with the winged gold or on the sword, it just fell off, and it was driving me absolutely nuts. In the end, I think I actually blue tagged it on. But yeah, the effects piece on the sword and the sword is good. The thing I don't like about the sword is they haven't put the gold outline going up the blade, which it has on the show. And I watched the show last night, so I know what his sword looked like. But yeah, here he is with his accessories in his hands. Love the face sculpt. Absolutely love it. The one thing I wish they had done is, or another thing I wish they had done is done an alternate head, so it looks as though, well, you guys know that when he's laughing, his mouth opens on MMPR. So I wish they'd done a second head. But I do know someone who's that 3D prints civilian heads and bounty heads. He also does weapons. So I'm going to get one off of him. And he also does Goldor's box to go with the Goldor's. So I'm going to get those off of him. Which is, he shouldn't have to do really, but unfortunately the way Hasbro do stuff at the moment, you have to, although they are kind of stepping up their game a bit now. Because if you've watched the Hasbro Pulse things, the last month or so, they've definitely stepped up their game. So I'll quickly turn him around and show you his back. This is what he looks like from the back. He has his wing stubs, which looked weird, but then they looked weird on the show, so there's not much difference there, really. Love the way the hair goes down his back. Love his tail piece, which they've actually nailed on the colour of the tail piece, and they've even got the face sculpt the right colour as well. I won't show you the articulation because it's the exact same articulation as the season 2 Goldor. But it's an absolutely great figure. The only thing I would say is different about this figure, well, there's a couple of things. One, the sword and the effects piece are completely different. They're a lot stronger. And obviously he has his wing stubs. Now, what I will say about this one is you can take the wing stubs out and you can put the Season 2 wings in the holes. But I'm going to say the Season 2 wings are really difficult to get out of that gold hole. So be careful if you do take them out that you don't break them. But I can't see why you would need to take them out and put them in this gold hole if you've already got the Season 2 gold hole. So yeah, that's my review on the Season 1 gold hole. My thoughts on him is I absolutely love him, except the colour. My ratings for him, I give him 4.5 out of 5 because of the colour, that's all. But yeah, that's it for now. Bye bye from Aaron.